Hello and welcome to this edition of Mornings. I'm Justine Yeh.
And I'm Rebecca Rosenblatt. Today is Tuesday, March 11th, 2014, and it is a sea day here at North Penn High School. Find out how much you know about world travel in this week's Brumbaugh Challenge.
Hey, welcome to this week's Brumbaugh Challenge. Here's a travel question. You ready? Here goes. Who has traveled further than any human being in history? The answer when we get back.
It was another action-packed weekend for the Knights and Maidens. The girls' basketball team defeated Lebanon in the first round of state playoffs on Friday night. They face Northampton tonight at Souderton at 6 p.m. Alex Price placed fifth in the wrestling state championships, and Jeff Remill competed at the state level as well. Girls and boys swimming and diving will be moving on to PIAA championships at Bucknell from Wednesday to Saturday. The ice hockey team was defeated by Parkland 5-2 in the Flyers Cup quarterfinal on Friday night. Congratulations to all teams for a great season, and good luck to those moving on to championships.
Students learned all about different colleges and prospective options at last week's college fair.
Hi, I'm Bill Travers, head of the North Penn High School Guidance Department. So the idea of a college fair is to bring students and colleges together. On a single evening, you can bring like 120 schools and all levels of higher education together, including the military, and you have an opportunity to have students get a chance to network, talk, gather information. Now, what we did this year, in conjunction with the Alumni Association, put together a mini career fair where we've got distinguished North Penn alums in a variety of fields. They're here to talk to our students and their families of, one, how they got in that career, and what were they doing like in terms of the selection of schools and majors. So for me, this is like a win-win night.
Mr. Monero is here with Sam Lee and Jonah Kim with SGA to talk about an upcoming event. Mr. Monero?
All right, good morning, Rebecca.
High school, actually, Sam and Jonah are here to talk about two things today. Hopefully, Jonah's cell phone doesn't go off this time around. Sam, you're going to start by talking about the talent show, which is coming up Friday night, right?
Yeah, it's coming up Friday night. I know you guys are all anticipating a great show. Tickets will be $5. And, make sure you come see us. It'll be at 7 o'clock.
And I think we still have viewer's choice opportunities, right? How's that work?
Yes. So at this point, we have three videos of viewer's choice videos. And whoever gets the most views by 7 o'clock on Thursday will be implemented, that their act will be implemented into the talent show.
All right. Outstanding. And also coming up very close, right around the corner, is the annual ICC volleyball tournament. And Jonah Kim is here to tell us all about that. Jonah, give us the details.
That's right, Mr. Monero. So the ICC volleyball tournament will be held March 18th. It'll be at 6:30, and we ask that all clubs participate. There will be a base price of $20, and then you can see Mr. Berger in D10 for paperwork and more information.
All right, good stuff. If you're going to the basketball game tonight, buy your tickets in school today because you get them $3 cheaper than you can at the door tonight. And we will be back a little bit later with an act from tonight's talent show. Back to the desk.
Do you know someone who could be our next president, perform on Broadway, most likely to be famous? The Accolade Yearbook staff has been hard at work creating the yearbook and is now inviting seniors to vote for their senior superlatives. The online form can be found under the Quick Links tab on the North Penn High School homepage. The link to senior write-ups or small bios students can write to go into the yearbook is under the Quick Links tab as well. Don't forget to fill out these forms soon.
The question squad wanted to know what your talents were in this week's question of the week.
Lauren can juggle. We can touch our nose with our tongue.
I'm a master of song and dance.
I can do really cool braids.
Irritating O'Brien and other liberals with my public speaking.
I'm not just irritated, I'm enraged.
I make fabulous creme brulee.
I can talk in my mouth closed.
I can do a backflip.
All right, the talent show is coming up on Friday night, and here to entice your appetites for that show is the lovely Nicole Sickle, who will be performing Death Cab for Cuties. I'll Follow You Into the Dark. Nicole Sickle.
Albert shows off his special talent in this week's I Know Funny.
Okay, in honor of this week's talent show, I'm gonna do my talent, which is impersonating Mr. Wilson. Let me get ready, here we go.
What does a nosy pepper do? Gets jalapeno business.
How's that? All right, good. I'm Mr. Wilson. That was the joke of the day.
All you need is love and a little bit of style. The 2014 fashion show featured styles from across the universe, that is, styles inspired by the Beatles' music and time period. It took more than just a hard day's night to create the garments. Fashion show students have been working 8 days a week since November to put on the annual fashion show. The talented students came together to strut down the aisle to popular tunes of the Beatles. Congratulations to all students involved. They will remember it like it was yesterday.
The Dudes search for Tyler in this week's Dude Report.
I gotta call Brett. Hello?
What's up?
Yeah, he's gone.
Who's gone?
Tyler. Yeah, he's lost.
What do you mean Tyler is lost?
I don't know, we were at KB Toys in the mall, and we were squeezing the bouncy balls to get syrup.
That's not where syrup comes from.
We gotta find him, I need your help.
All right, I'll be right there.
Okay. This is dire circumstance.
Yo, is this a, oh hey.
Oh my gosh.
All right, tell me what happened.
I just don't.
All right, so you were in a KB Toys, and you were trying to get maple syrup from... Why are you looking
what?
At me like that?
That's not what
you
I
told
said.
Me.
No, I said we were in the village, all right? We were saving orphans from a fire.
That's Definitely not what you told
Absolutely
me.
Absolutely it is.
Alright, what actually happened?
Yeah, I really don't know. I'm pretty sure we were at his house and then, I don't know. You know? I just wish he left us something. I don't even know. I don't know what's... I don't know. Yeah, I don't know what happened. We're just gonna have to go look for him, I guess.
You know what that means.
What? Road trip!
Let's do this.
Why are you wearing a hat?
Why aren't you wearing a hat?
I'm glad you asked. Let's ride.
If you're like me and you want Darren Ruff to make this big league team, the way I see it playing out.
Close your eyes.
Find him.
Yeah, dude, this is a matter of complete urgency.
Pretty scary, right? I'm not gonna lie. We gotta fast and furious this stuff right now.
Did you figure it out yet?
I'm trying to decide between these two different kinds of mac and cheese or a garbage bag.
What were we doing before this?
It wasn't important.
Alright, let's go.
Alright.
Oh. Well, I don't really have enough gas to get anywhere else.
So
I think we should go home.
We should head back.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool.
Let's check in with Mr. Brumbaugh to find out the answer to this week's Brumbaugh Challenge.
Hey, welcome back. The answer you've all been waiting for. Russia's Sergei Avdeyev, a Russian cosmonaut, orbited the Earth nearly 12,000 times. Bet you didn't know that? Now you do. Thanks for playing this week's Brumbaugh Challenge.
The winner of this week's Brumbaugh Challenge is Mrs. McGinsey in A122. That's it for this edition of Mornings. I'm Rebecca Rosenblatt.
And I'm Justine Ye. Have a brilliant day, North Penn.